गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव लर्न अबाउट एयर पॉल्यूशन, इट्स काउजेज एंड इट्स इफेक्ट्स। टुडे आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग अबाउट वाटर पॉल्यूशन एंड इट्स हार्मफुल इफेक्ट्स। ऑल ऑफ यू नो वाटर इज अ प्रीसियस रिसोर्स, इट इज एसेंशियल फॉर ऑल लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज फॉर सर्वाइवल और देयर एग्जिस्टेंस। वी नीड वाटर फॉर आवर वेरियस एक्टिविटीज लाइक कुकिंग, वॉशिंग, रनिंग ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज, एग्रीकल्चर एंड ऑल्सो इन मेनी अदर एक्टिविटीज। यू नो वाटर इज बिकमिंग स्कार्स ड्यू टू इंक्रीज इन पॉपुलेशन, इंडस्ट्रीज एंड एग्रीकल्चरल एक्टिविटीज। वाटर इज ऑल्सो पॉल्यूटेड बाय ह्यूमन एक्टिविटीज। एवरी डे मेनी अनवांटेड एंड हार्मफुल सब्सटेंसेस आर डिस्चार्ज इन टू द वाटर बॉडीज लाइक रिवर्स, लेक्स एंड इन दिस वे वाटर गेट्स पॉल्यूटेड। The unwanted and harmful substances which makes water impure are called water pollutants. The major water pollutants which cause water pollution are sewage, fertilizers, pesticides, and industrial waste. All these water pollutants are harmful and dangerous to human beings, animals and plants. Some pollutants can even cause death. Hot water from power plants and industries is also considered a pollutant. This is because when very hot water coming from power plants and industries is discharged into a river or lake, it raises the temperature of the river water, and the rise in the temperature of the river water has an adverse effect on the animals and plants living in it. So what are the cause of water pollution and what are the sources of water pollutants? You see, toxic substances dissolve in water or gets deposited into the bay. Toxic substances enter lakes, rivers, streams, etc. Pollutants go into the ground, and the source of water pollution are mainly sewage, industrial waste, agricultural runoff. All of you know Ganga is one of the most famous rivers of the India. It sustains most of the northern, central and eastern Indian population. Millions of people depend on it for their daily needs and livelihood. However, recently a study by the Worldwide Fund for Nature found that Ganga is one of the 10 most endangered river in the world. The pollution level have been rising for many years. We have reached this stage because the towns and cities through which the river flows throw large quantities of garbage, untreated sewage, dead bodies and many other harmful things directly into the river. In fact, the pollution levels are so high that aquatic life cannot survive. So, by this story, you know what are the causes of water pollution. The Ganga River, the case study of Ganga. The Ganga is the largest river in the India and second greatest river in the world, with an extraordinary religious importance for Hindus, worshipped as goddess Ganga in Hinduism. Along its bank are some of the world's oldest inhabited places like Varanasi and Patna. It provides water to about 40% of India's population in 11 states. In modern time, it is known for being very polluted. So, you see, by this figure, how does water get polluted? So, both groundwater and surface water get polluted by human activities. You see, what are the sources of water pollution of Ganga River? Sources mean point source means sewage effluent, domestic waste, industrial effluent, leather industry. Non-point source means solid waste, bathing and washing on ghat, agricultural runoff and cremation. So cause of pollution in river Ganga, you see in this figure also. Religious waste, municipal waste, industrial waste, dead bodies, domestic waste. These are the cause of pollution in river Ganga. For restoring the past glory of Ganga, government also launched some plan. Ganga Action Plan 1 is launched in January 1986. Ganga Action Plan 2 launched in April 1993. And Namami Ganga launched in June 2014. And the aim of the plan are to restore the glory of Ganga or to save Ganga. So you understand the cause of water pollution. The next topic is potable water and water purification. The water which is fit for drinking or we use for drinking purpose is called potable water. You have seen how various physical and chemical processes in the sewage treatment plant help to clean water before discharging it into the water bodies. Similarly, municipal bodies treat the water before supplying it to household. Do you know 25% of the world population is without safe drinking water? How is water purified? You have already seen how water is filtered. This is a physical method of removing impurities. A popular household filter is candle type filter. Many households use boiling as a method for obtaining safe drinking water because boiling kills the germs present in the water. Chlorination is a commonly used chemical method for purifying water. It is done by adding chlorine tablets or bleaching powder to the water. So we must be cautious because we should not use more chlorine tablets than specified. We can think of creative ideas like reusing water used for washing and for other household tasks. For example, water used for washing vegetables may be used to water plants in the garden. So pollution is no longer if we adopt 4R principle, we save our water body, because if we drink polluted water, we suffer from various disease or waterborne disease. So for controlling water pollution. We should not discharge industrial waste into the water body. We should not discharge untreated sewage into the water body. So there are various ways for treatment of water bodies. So you study the case study of Ganga River, you learn Ganga Action Plan.